Welcome to the third episode of Drive and Delivers with me, Atlanta Delivers. This is my podcast talking about everything delivering, such as news updates, my stories delivering, your stories delivering, statistics, everything to do with delivering. I hope you're enjoying the podcast so far. I upload an episode every other Wednesday at 6 p.m. So make sure to hit that like button and subscribe. We're getting closer to 10,000 subscribers, so please hit that subscribe button. Very much appreciated. And any comments as well is also very appreciated. If you have any delivery stories or any customer stories, then please pop them down in the comments or come and join my Facebook delivery group and you can pop them in there as well. If you don't know me already, my name's Atlanta and I've been a delivery driver for 4.5 years. Over 3 years of that, I delivered in the car. Well, I deliver in the car now. So at the beginning, I was in the car and then I swapped to electric bikes for a year and now have swapped back to a car. So I've got a good knowledge of the industry and researching about everything as well is really interesting. I found it rather interesting and everything I talk about that I found information from somewhere, I will pop the links down below so that you can have a look as well if you are interested. First of all, we're going to talk about news updates. So the first thing I found was released on the 16th of October on Just Eat's website. And I've never actually been on Just Eat's website before. It was to do with how Just Eat are enhancing the user's experience through innovation. So it was quite interesting. There's a couple of parts to this, but the main one that caught my eye, at the minute, AI is becoming such a big thing. Like, my thumbnail of the video came out last week or the week before on Sunday. It used AI to change the image. So it was like a normal thumbnail picture I took, and because it was coming out Christmas Eve, AI added in Christmas decorations and stuff, and it looks so real. It's really weird. Check out that thumbnail, check out the video, of course. But Just Eat are starting to introduce, as a trial for some people, AI on the Just Eat app or website. So when you go to order, you can just type to AI saying, I want to, the example that they've used that will pop on the screen is, I want to order an Egg McMuffin from McDonald's, and it will put it just straight in your basket, and that will work for everything. So at the minute, yeah, it is a trial, it's not foolproof of working yet, but that's pretty crazy, and it's definitely got positives and negatives, I'd say, or not negatives. I think it will need a lot of development to get it right, of when you just type in something that is just going to put it in your basket, or I don't know, hopefully it'll have a breakdown of, say I want pasta, and it'll be like, do you want it from this place, and if it could give you the prices and stuff, if there's any offers. I think, yeah, it needs a lot of developing, but it definitely could work quite well, and for it to work quickly as well, if you want to be like, hey, just want to order this quickly, boom, done. It definitely could work. Another thing that was in this article was to do with robots, which robots have been around a little while now delivering, but it's never become that big of a thing. Like where I live down in Worthing, I've never seen any down in the south. I made a video in Northampton and I saw some delivering there and they're very cute. But they're currently trialing on Just Eat in the US and Poland, so not even in the UK at the minute. But let me know in the comments your opinions on the robots. It's good, it's bad. I'd say some of the positives is, especially for the environment, it's much better for the environment. If there's no drivers around and they've got the robots, then the robots are ready to go. It's cheaper for the restaurants or shops to use robots rather than humans. But I'd say there is more negatives involved of several things. So the robots can get stuck. That's not good. You have to charge up the robots and that's going to take a while, I'd say. They can't take heavy orders, or maybe they can take heavy orders. They can't take a large order. They can't probably go that long of a distance. So I don't know. I feel like, go back ages ago, like years ago, and you'd be like, oh yeah, it's going to be like robots delivering by 2023, 2024. But I don't think we're anywhere close to that. And I don't think we ever will be, because, yeah, I don't think so. I think there's too many negatives involved to be able to have robots all the time. And also you get no customer interaction. I mean, you could have a little robot talking to you, which is kind of cute, but I think a lot of people still want human interaction. Like, as a delivery driver, actually someone commented something yesterday which made me realize this, that as a delivery driver, just having a quick chat with a customer, a lot of the time it's just, hi, here's your order, have a good day. But sometimes you have like a little chat with a customer and it can make the customer's day. So yeah, we need to not lose that. A bit more of a light-hearted story that I saw on a news article, not very funny for the customers, is that one driver stole an order of £70 worth of food. The customer, after 2 hours, obviously you can track it as a customer, and went to the location where the driver was in the park. And the driver was there with another driver eating the food, which says pictures been taken of the drivers. Just Eat has responded to this, that they are looking into it. It's hard to know if it's true or not. I suppose it probably is true, but surely as a driver you'd realise you're being tracked, no? And Just Eat would message you in the app as well, be like, hey, what's going on? But I suppose the driver can ignore that. If you are a driver, don't steal food. Definitely not a good idea. That's no fun for a customer, and you're probably going to lose your job. So now I'm going to talk about some new things that I've seen in the past week or so. And the first one being that I didn't even realise, Pizza Express has joined on Just Eat. I thought that was always a thing. I'm really confused. I still feel like I shouldn't be saying that as a sentence. And I double checked like to make sure that this was accurate. And that's what it says. So I don't know. I feel like it was always a thing, but apparently not. This is good, obviously, for Just Eat and good for Pizza Express, but I suppose may have a little negative effect on Uber Eats and Deliveroo that already deliver orders. So obviously it's going to decrease the amount of orders they get on the other platforms, I would say. But the positive is it just puts out Pizza Express name out there more for a delivery service, which then customers could compare the apps, all three of them, and work out which one's the cheapest for like delivery fees or prices, if there's any deals. So potentially it could increase the business as well, but definitely is a positive for Pizza Express itself. Also, Pizza Express has launched their own delivery service. Well, I say that it's similar to how like KFC is. So for Pizza Express, you'll order either on the app or the website and it'll look like you're ordering from Pizza Express directly, but it's partnered with Uber Eats. So an Uber Eats driver will actually be delivering it even though you are ordering through Pizza Express. Another thing that I have noticed a lot of in the past week in my Facebook delivery group, make sure to come and join so you can get involved with the podcast. Also, I'm just going to say one thing before I go into that. If you want to become a member on this channel, you can see all my videos early and it is a big help to me. It will support me a lot. So top line of the description, become a member, and yeah, it helps me out a lot. But anyway, in my Facebook delivery group, I saw that the Uber Eats pay seems to have dropped drastically. So to me, it's a car delivery driver, the minimum is £3, and a bike rider I think is £2.80 or £2.90. But people have been posting screenshots and I thought maybe it's a glitch, but more and more people are posting the low pay they're being offered on Uber Eats, and not as an add-on order, like a second or third order, as one order. As low as £1.86 has been posted in my group. There's been several, like £2.20, £2.21, £1.93, £1.86. That is crazy. I really hope no one is taking that, because I'm someone that does take £3 orders if they're easy, and that is low already. But I really hope no one has taken the ones then any less than that, because that is absolutely mental. The main focus of last week's episode of the podcast was to do with how our pay needs to increase, and it still seems to be decreasing. The pay really needs to go up because everything's going up in price and our pay is not, and it's still going down. I've said this several times. Compared to when I started in 2019, before COVID, because COVID pay went up a lot and it was great, but not COVID itself, just the pay of delivering and busyness and stuff. But the pay in 2019 compared to now, the pay is lower than in 2019. Like, how is that a thing with everything gone up in price so much? I don't know what we can do really, but yeah, not good. Another thing that I saw on Deliveroo's LinkedIn was to do with Deliveroo becoming 10 years old this year, which was back in May. And it was showing the Deliveroo rider box now compared to 10 years ago in 2013. The bags and boxes are always currently changing. Like, ever since I've started, they're currently developing the bags and boxes and stuff. And the logo, like, occasionally changes, but not by much. But since the start, it's changed a lot. I don't actually know which one I prefer, whether I like... So I quite like the black. I think it's just quite classy, but obviously, like, the greeny blue now stands out a lot more. And the kangaroo's kind of cute. I don't know which one I prefer. Let me know which one you prefer. And also, I wanted to ask, if I was to bring out my own delivery bag, because I'm thinking about... I have actually sold a delivery bag before on Amazon. I'm thinking about creating my own one and having, like, my logo or something on it. Would you get one? Let me know, because I'd love to start doing some merch. And I'm thinking a delivery bag would be pretty cool, because, well, it's fitting and it's something that is very practical for delivery drivers. So, yeah, let me know. That would be really cool. And obviously, it would take a long time. This is me just, like, saying it out of the blue kind of thing, and it would obviously take a while to be able to actually do that, like, months. But let me know what you think. One more thing that someone commented in my Facebook delivery group was to do with Uber Eats triple orders. Now, Uber Eats triple orders have been around quite a while. I have made videos doing them before, but I feel like they don't come up that frequently. But by the sounds of it, they are becoming a bit more frequent. This, I believe, can only be from one restaurant or one shop that you can get a triple order, rather than imagine going to three different restaurants. That would be crazy. That would take too long. Even if they were already, that would take way too long. I think I've only actually ever had triple orders at Tesco for Whoosh deliveries, which I think is fine because they're obviously, like, it's not hot food. But there was a video I made, and, like, I filled up two delivery bags, like a big backpack, my normal delivery bag, and it was still too much. So if you're on a bike, that's definitely not practical, unless I guess they're all really small orders. But I think it's a bad idea to do it from a restaurant, because three orders, it's just, that just takes a long time, and you've got hot food sitting there. So let me know, because I don't know if it, I assume it is restaurants as well, I'm pretty sure it is, but I don't think it's that practical, even though the pay can be okay for them, but not incredible, and does definitely take a while to do it. Now, moving on to a couple of delivery stories that I have that I've experienced over my time delivering. So the first one I'm going to talk about is when I delivered to Lady C's Castle, which is just outside where I live, and I've now delivered there twice. Well, once to the castle and once to, like, a house by it that I believe they work at the castle, work for Lady C, something like that. And I got an order on Deliveroo. This was a little while ago now. I got an order on Deliveroo for Pizza Express, turned up to the restaurant, and then that's when you put that you've arrived and it will show you the order. Now, the order was for, like, 30 pizzas, and I was like, oh, okay. But several riders had been sent. So when I went in, I was, like, the last rider, and they were, just gave me one pizza, and I was like, oh, okay. And it was for a mess up of a pizza that had already been delivered. So I got the one pizza and then started to make my way there, which was quite a few miles. And when I was driving there, I was getting a call from the customer, which was someone that was working on the film set. It was basically, they were filming at the castle that day, and the lady called me and she's like, what's going on? And I'm like, oh, okay, I've just picked up one pizza for a pizza that's been messed up, I'm on my way. She wasn't happy, and then continued to ask me where, like, the drivers were and everything, and I'm like, I don't know. Anyway, I'm a nice person. So I called up Pizza Express and I'm like, hi, do you know, like, how many riders there is and all this? And I think there was, like, five or six riders or something. So quite a lot of riders. So then I called her back, or she called me back, and I explained that there's quite a few riders. I don't know where everyone is, but everyone is on their way. There's no one at the restaurant. Everything's been collected. Still wasn't happy. I can't remember after that. I'm sure she called me again to find out what was going on. But I turned up, dropped off my one pizza, wasn't the happiest. I mean, fair enough, if you've got like 5 or 6 different riders, you're all trying to eat together and you've got pizzas all over the place and stuff, yeah, that's probably not that ideal. But yeah, that happened. There wasn't a tip on the order, but I suppose you'd have to tip like 5 drivers. If you did it on the app, it would split 5 ways or whatever. But anyway, a bit chaotic and not ideal for the customer or riders really. And I turned up still before other riders, and I was last to go, so I don't know where the other riders disappeared to. Hopefully they got all their pizzas. Another story I have for you / question is, what's the weirdest order you have delivered? Let me know in the comments. So I'd say a couple of my weirdest orders is, one is just 1 sweet corn from KFC. That's quite random, and they paid loads for it. Actually, another one I had similar was like a McDonald's wrap, and because it was just one wrap, they paid something like £12 or something for it, mental with all the charges. And the other order that I found really weird, right, which isn't actually a weird order, but in my head, it was 2 items from a shop, and in my head, they're eating this together. I just can't get out of my head, was Revels, which is chocolate and mayonnaise. Like, when I read that and I delivered it, all I can think is that they're eating Revels and mayonnaise together, which I'm sure they're not. I mean, fair enough if you are. I'm sure they're not. But that's all I could get in my head. My mum still thinks it's weird that sometimes I deliver just like 1 coffee, but to me that's pretty normal. I suppose it's quite an expensive way, but sometimes I think it's nice to treat yourself. I probably have a Starbucks, like, I don't drink coffee, but I probably have Starbucks like 1 or 2 a year, and it's like a nice treat, isn't it? Like, I have like a caramel frappuccino, no coffee, and it is a nice treat, so I kind of get just ordering 1, but yeah, my mum finds that strange. The next story I'm going to talk about is kind of a story / statement, I'm not too sure, is I just wanted to talk about when I first started delivering, it was really uncommon for there to be women drivers. Now it's pretty normal, like there's quite a lot of women drivers. I still think as a ratio there's a lot more men than women delivering, but like when I started there was hardly any, and this would be commented on pretty constantly, like either when I pick up, dropping off, it was really common to be like, oh, a woman delivering my food, that's so weird. No one really says it now, like occasionally I get it, but like very occasionally now, but it used to be so common. But I suppose back then there was a lot less riders, so yeah, I don't know, it still seems to be fairly common. Let me know in your area, because I was doing a documentary last year, I think it was for International Women's Day for Deliveroo, and they're like about women drivers, and I'm like, oh, there's quite a few women drivers in my area, which I weren't expecting. And apparently a lot of areas there isn't. So I'm interested to know now if it's still the same or not, because there's quite a few in my area now. The final story, I'm actually going to insert a clip now. So I've just had a situation that a driver has tried slagging me off to myself, not realizing it was me. He was like, oh, it's been quiet, I haven't seen him before. And then he was like, oh, that girl in the newspaper putting, she earned £1,000 in a week. Now there's drivers coming from Lansing and Brighton to work here and all this. And I was like, yeah, that's me. And he was like, what? I was like, yeah, that's me. Then he carried on for a little bit and then like backed away from me. But I'm like, okay. I'm like, yeah, that was the title. Yeah, because I did a YouTube video earning £1,000 in a week, as most of you will know. But it's not what I do every week. I never said that. The article doesn't say that either. So at some point I will talk about the £1,000 week delivering in a lot more detail on an episode of this podcast. But if you do want to check it out, it's in 3 parts. One of the videos, I think it's the first part, is one of my top videos, so you can check it out that way. Or just search like £1,000 week delivering. Spoiler, I did do it. I don't think it's very possible to do it now, but I will talk about that more detail in another episode. The next segment that I'm going to be talking about is behind the scenes as a driver, things you may not know as a customer. The next segment I'm going to talk about is behind the scenes as a driver, things you may not know as a customer, and some things you may not know as a driver as well. The first part of this that I'm going to talk about is us as drivers are self-employed and we do not work for the restaurants. So I actually asked in my, well, my moderators on my Facebook delivery group, we've got a little group chat, and I was like, hey, need some ideas, because I was a little bit struggling of ideas for behind the scenes. If you have any, please let me know for the next episode. And they were like, about how a lot of people still think we're employed or self-employed for the restaurants itself. So we don't touch your orders, we don't pack them, nothing. So one of them was like, oh, so if like the dips are forgotten, that's not our fault, so don't blame us. And then that reminded me of actually last week when I delivered an order. It did feature in one of my videos. I got to the drop off and the customer was like, oh, can I just check the order, because sometimes they're missing things. And I'm like, well, yeah, you can, but I didn't say it like this abruptly or anything. You can check it, but if there's something missing, I do not work for the restaurant, and I will not be going back to go and get your item, because that is not my job. I just pick up an order, drop it off. I don't get involved with anything else. So just bear that in mind, because obviously a lot of people do not know that. And if you are missing an item on any of the apps, then what you need to do is contact the company itself on like the app or website, wherever you ordered. There should be a section to either speak to someone live or just report you're missing an item, and then they will refund it or give you credit, something along the lines of that. But the driver, it's not their problem. The next thing I'm going to talk about is how we're paid as delivery drivers. So as I just mentioned, we are self-employed, which means we pay our own tax and national insurance. But the way we get paid is not hourly, we get paid per delivery. So this means 1 hour we could earn £3, 1 hour we could earn £20. For me, like, you have your up and down hours, but in general, the pay does average out okay. Nothing crazy, sometimes can be good pay, but normally like minimum wage-ish, I'd say, is pretty average for my area. I know other areas are different. Some people do earn less and some people earn more. But for Just Eat, we are paid for the distance from where we are when we accept the order to the restaurant and then to the customer. So we're paid for the whole distance. Whereas with Uber Eats and Deliveroo, we're paid just from the restaurant to the customer. There might be, if you're far away, a slight increase, but not by much. So in general, Just Eat is the company that pays the most for us to deliver. But Just Eat is the only one that you have to have shifts, which can be a bit difficult to get, and still on your shifts can be quiet. So just bear that in mind, that a driver could have literally earned like £3 in an hour. And if you do want a tip, it'd be very much appreciated as a driver. I know there's different opinions on if you should tip or not, but just think about that your driver could have earned £5 in the last 2 hours or something. So yeah, obviously you can have good hours, can have bad hours, but that's how our pay works. I will now be talking about some facts and statistics that I've found to do with the gig economy and delivering. A lot of what I'm going to talk about in this part is from a single document that I found very interesting, and that document will be linked down below. As usual, my laptop is coming up for this part, so that any figures I have, I won't mess up, because that won't be too ideal. So the document that is from this year is called The Gig Economy, What Does It Really Look Like? So it has different figures and statistics all to do with the gig economy, which, yeah, is interesting. The first chart that I will insert on the screen now is to do with the statistics of how many people are self-employed from 2010 to 2023. Obviously, there was a big increase during COVID, and it has dropped since, and we're now level with, and the figure now has dropped back to similar to 2013 and 2014, which I think is pretty crazy. Obviously, during lockdown time, 2019, 2020, there were many reasons why a lot of people, do I mean 2019? 2020, 2021? I think that's what I mean. No, yes, whenever COVID was, there was many reasons why people became self-employed, whether they were furloughed and wanted something to do, furloughed and needed to make some extra money, had some time off and just wanted to give something else a go. People lost their jobs, sadly, during that time and needed a new way to make money. So yeah, and specifically to delivering, During that time, there was a lot of drivers that started, and since now there is a lot less drivers. So I'd say when I first started delivering, there was like quite a low amount of drivers. COVID, there was a lot of drivers, and now it's like an in-between, I'd say. I think there's definitely more drivers than there used to be when I started, but like nowhere near the amount of people delivering as during COVID. You wouldn't need that amount anymore because there's not as many orders as there was during that time. And a lot of the drivers now have gone back to like their normal work, so they don't need delivering or just doing it very part-time. The next chart that I looked at was to do with how many people, I spoke about this last week, how many people see delivering as their main source of income. But this chart is to do with that by age. My age group is the lowest with 15%, which is age 16 to 24, followed by ages 35 to 49 with 19%, followed by 20% being aged 25 to 34, and the highest with 23% being aged 50 and over. I am quite surprised that that is the highest, the eldest, but I thought about it for a little while and I'm like, why is that? I find that quite strange because I don't feel like I see that many older people out delivering, or not in my area at least. But then I thought about it that there is probably way, way more people my age and like the age groups above delivering, like up to like 30s. So as a percentage, because there is way more of us delivering my age, but a lot of those won't be full-time and see it as a main source of income, the percentage then works out probably, or change it, the amount of people who rely on it as a main income could be the same or more for my ages, but because there's so many more people as a percentage, that it works out that there's less people relying it on a main source of income, if that makes sense. The last graph that I'm going to talk about is a graph that shows the amount of gig workers who rely on the income as their main source, comparing figures of being employed compared to self-employed. I wanted to read that straight off of there, because when I was writing that, I was like, oh my goodness, that's like feels like a confusing sentence. So the results of this don't surprise me at all. 74% of people who rely on it as a main source of income are self-employed, and 26% are employed. 66% of people who do not rely on it as a main income are employed, and 34% are self-employed. So I would say the main reason for this is, so like drivers like me that are self-employed and see it as a main source of income, I'd say rather than working for a specific company and you're employed or self-employed through like, I don't know, an Indian takeaway or something, those are probably going to be part-time hours that aren't open in the day or have like, yeah, just a few hours in the evening. Whereas like Deliveroo, Uber Eats, Just Eat, you can work this whenever and there is always going to be orders, and for that you are going to be self-employed. I would say if you're not doing like what I'm doing, that you're probably not relying it on a main source of income, or a lot less as shown in the percentages. So as a rider like myself for the companies, it does give you the flexibility to work where you want, when you want, and if it is your full-time job, you can work as much as you want to. So I'm now going to talk about and answer some of your questions. So if you do have any questions to do with delivering, then pop them down below in the comments or in the delivery group on Facebook. So the first question I'm going to answer that I was asked was, how far do I travel into my area or into my town to start delivering? I'm very lucky that where I live, I can start delivering straight away. I know that's unfortunately not for everyone, but for myself, I'm in the area that I work, which is really cool. Sometimes if I don't get an order straight away, like over here, I drive about 10 minutes into Worthing and wait there. But a lot of the time, I can just start straight away where I am. The next question asked is, I'm originally from the UK, now living in Florida, and I'm curious if acceptance rate matters in the UK. Do you mind sharing your stats? Thank you for your question, and I will break this down into each app. So Deliveroo, I have had a meeting with Deliveroo before, and they did tell me because I did ask the acceptance rate that we can't see anyway. Doesn't matter on delivery, it won't affect the amount of orders you get, which I do believe is true. I've never really seen a difference if I've rejected loads of orders from Deliveroo. Just Eat, we do have an acceptance rate which is out of 100%, and this is based on the last 10 deliveries that you have completed. I think mine at the moment is set around 80 or 90%. It's like nearly at the top. Might even be 100, maybe 80, 90, somewhere up there, but I always try and keep it high because I did in COVID reject a load of orders. I think it was all for McDonald's when I wasn't banned, and it did really affect me. So I got it down to like 0%. The next few months after that, I really struggled to get orders. Like, it was not good at all. So I'd say Just Eat does penalize you for having a lower acceptance rate. And then Uber Eats, I don't think it matters. There was a time for literally a couple of weeks where it would show you your satisfaction score, which still is there, and your acceptance rate, and then that disappeared. I don't know if you still have it in America. Let me know, because I think you might do and it does affect you. But I don't believe it affects us here. The only thing we have, like I said, is the satisfaction scoring, which is based on the last 100 customers and restaurants to give you a thumbs up or thumbs down, which mine currently is at 99%. So I've had one thumbs down. Could do with getting, like, it has to have to get through all the deliveries of thumbs up to them for that to filter out. So it can take a long time. The last question I'm going to answer is, can you change the schedule of multi-drops for the drop-offs? That sounds confusing. So if you have like a double order or triple order, even Uber Eats, Deliveroo, Just Eat, whatever company it is, tell you which drop-off to go to first, and you have to follow the order it tells you. So to answer your question, no, you can't change it. All the apps in theory give you the best one to go to first. Sometimes I know that can be a little bit questionable, but for the most part it makes sense. So it will just tell you where your first drop off is, then you drop it off, press you've done it, and then it will send you to the next one, and you have to just follow the order it gives you. And yeah, they've done it so that it does make sense. And finally, I'm going to move on to a couple of your stories. So if you please do have any stories, let me know, because yeah, I need your stories so we can talk about them. They can be anonymous. I've never mentioned anyone's names. And I'm actually going to read a couple from Instagram that I got messages of, because I put it on my story the other day. Instagram's Atlanta Delivers, if you want to check that out as well. Give it a follow, update my life daily there. And a couple of people messaged me some stories, and I'm going to read them to you. I'm going to read this one first. I was laughing at this one quite hard. So it says, so me and my friend lived with another guy and we had ordered a pizza. This other guy was out and we were going to scare him, so we got him to tell us when he was coming home. We left the door open a bit, turned off all the lights. There was a knock at the door. We had forgotten we ordered the pizza. We kept ignoring the knocking, hoping he would come in, and he never. And we thought, why is he knocking to come in his own house? So we shouted, come in, still completely forgetting about the pizza, not knowing this was the delivery driver. So he steps in the door and we jump out, and he got such a fright, he threw the pizza. I was laughing very hard at that. That, like, that wouldn't be funny as a driver. And I'm sure you probably weren't laughing at the time, but it sounds like something I'd do. I've definitely done that to someone before. Go to scare someone thinking it was someone and then it's not. I remember doing that like years ago to a random person instead of like jumping out on my dad. So I'd like, that gave me a flashback of that. But imagine, poor driver. He did also say though, I was like, oh my goodness, that they did tip him good because they felt so bad and they thought it was his friend coming in. I was amused by that story. And then the other story that was sent to me on Instagram was, I once nearly got in a fist fight with a Just Eat driver in my shop. He didn't believe the order was for me and got really aggressive. Yeah, he was like, not really what you mean, I know, but it was funny. So yeah, he nearly got in a fight with the driver because the driver didn't believe. I don't know how that happened. I'm not too sure. Why would the driver not believe it's for you? I guess they thought it was going to, I know where this is, where I got my tattoos. They probably thought it was for like the flats above or something, and they, you were trying to steal the order. But yeah, then he said, luckily he backed off, haha. So yeah, that wouldn't be good. Imagine getting in a fight with the driver, that would not be good. Like, just give me my food. Imagine if you've ordered and you're really hungry and you get hangry and you're like, just give me my food. So I hope you enjoyed this episode of Drive and Delivers with me, Atlanta Delivers. Like I said, podcast episode every other Wednesday at 6 p.m. and I upload a delivery video every Sunday at 10 a.m. So please hit that like button and subscribe. Appreciate you all listening and I love you all. See you soon. See you Sunday at 10 a.m. Bye!